body grip that you want, but now you don't have those in, and your partner's going to have their knees pulling their chest and hands on the outside. So now your goal is the same as before, control the position as long as you can. And the longer you are sitting here without any control of your legs, the faster he's going to escape. So your first goal is to start to try to use your legs to get in the position that you control. What you want to think about doing, so you're not going for submissions, but you can always use this grip, this rear end of your grip, as a way to control it. As long as you have to sit here with your hands out, you can use your hands to control his neck, right? And you'll see, when you do this, somebody, their hands almost always come up to the fence. He's blocking their feet from coming in, and grab his neck, that's going to bring his hands up. At least one of them to try to fight my wrist and pull away. And when he does that, I can use that as a chance to get a hook. Once I get one in, that to go to the other side. I don't have to hold his choking mark and bring my hands back. I can use his hand to control his other hand, trap, and then bring your other hand in. When you don't have your feet inside, wrapped around the body, it doesn't mean that you can't use it. So you can use your feet instead of going from the foot inside, you can hook from the outside. So you use your feet to sort of hook behind his ankles. This is actually a really strong way to control somebody, even if they're on your side here. It's going to be a lot of control over the person's legs. And you also, when you don't have your legs, then you're going to have to use different upper body grips. Right, so one of the best is, again, using this choke grip, using the seatbelt with the Kimura grip, or even using just the Kimura grip without the head. So get used to using this grip. And this one, this is one of the strongest you can use when you don't have leg control. How about this? When the person ends up like this, as long as you keep control of his elbow and keep it off the floor, he's not going to be able to turn. This way, for example. He's not going to be able to turn away. You can use this to move yourself to him, move your hip in. So you can use that to get your leg back. So the other thing you want to focus on is. A lot of times you're only going to have one hook. Right? He's going to be really fighting to keep this one off. If he's blocking, he's going to get my right hook in. I'm going to focus everything on controlling his right shoulder. So I control my left leg or his left leg. I'm going to control his right shoulder with my right hook. This is going to allow me now I can stretch it out, get the hook in, get him in the chest. And even if I can't get this hook in, as long as I control this, it's very hard to go under. I just have both sides of his body controlled. And then he uses to get to his neck. But again, when I go up to submissions, I'm just going to use this grip as a way to control it. Right, so focus on finding different ways to use your legs to control the person. You're ultimately looking to get your legs inside. And make sure you're switching your upper body because you're using